Hi, it's Chris from Crochet Recreations by Chris Loves Crochet. And today we're going to do a Mobius headband. So the Mobius is just is usually a cowl and it has a little twist in it. We're going to make a 30-minute headband. So if you still have any gifts to put together or a birthday present or whenever you're watching this, you could do this in 30 minutes right before. Just take a shower 30 minutes early. Do your present and throw it in a bag and go. So I'm going to be using ice yarns, a partially used ice yarn. This is Cake's Wool Chunky Colors. And it's got some purple and some orange and red and turquoise and green in there. Some pretty colors. It calls for, it has 160 meters. It's 30% wool, 70% acrylic. 200 grams, 160 meters, I said, and it calls for knitting needles 8 to 10 millimeters. So we always go up one, so it's 9 to 11 millimeter on a crochet hook, and this is the number 6, super bulky. So between 9 and 11 is 10, so I'm going to get out my 10 millimeter crochet hook, if I can find it. Should have had it out. I didn't. Here we go. 10 millimeter crochet hook. And it's purple, is my clover 10 millimeter. We're gonna need a measuring tape, my brain. And we're gonna need a large eye embroider needle to sew in the tails. And we're gonna need some scissors. And I always keep, when I start a project, I always keep a stitch marker at hand. I don't leave projects without putting a stitch marker into the last stitch. I have dogs, so if you have any animals around the house, including small children, I can say that, I'm a mom, it's okay. You don't want to leave your work just sitting there without a stitch marker holding your place, or you're going to lose some stuff. So, anyway. So, in order to do this, what we're going to use, what we're going to do is a foundation treble crochet. Now, I just did a tutorial on that, and so I'll put in the upper left-hand corner, upper right-hand corner, the link to that tutorial so that you can see how to do the foundation. I've already measured around my head and to know that I need 22 inches. That's about average. So I'm going to have my measuring tape out at 22 inches. It goes off the camera, but it's at 22 inches so that I can just keep doing. I don't have a number for the number of foundation trebles that I'm going to do, but I'm just going to do it to 22 inches. How about that? So, which is about 22 inches is about average for a lady's headband. So we're going to start with a little bit of a tail there, so I have something to sew in. It won't be hanging there. Slip knot. Pull it down on your hook so that you still have room to grow. A treble is 4 high, so we go 4 plus 1. Yarn over twice, go into the first chain, yarn over, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through that first loop, pinch down on it, yarn over, pull through 2, pull through 2, pull through 2. So the chain is a treble, and then we just did a foundation treble. So I'm going to do this for 22 inches. And like I said, if you need to see a little bit slower, a little bit more description on the foundation or the chainless foundation stitches, click on that link and go check it out. So I'm going to do this. Oh, that was a double. What was I thinking? Yarn over twice for the treble. Yarn over 1 to get another chain, yarn over, pull through 2, pull through 2, pull through 2. Okay, so I'm going to do that for 22 inches, and I'll be back. So mine is 22 inches long now. I hope yours is too. And so I can put away this measuring tape. And what makes a Mobius, if you do it with the twist in the middle and don't do it at the end, so it comes around like this. So we just finished on this side. It doesn't really matter because the front and back will both be showing. But as we come around, we're not going to slip stitch it here. And we are going to take this that we, at the front end, the beginning, and turn it like that. So we have the back of the treble showing and the front of the treble showing, which I don't mind. I like the back of the treble too. So what we're going to do, no, we're not going to slip stitch to that. What we're going to do is we're going to continue making treble crochets. But now we already have a foundation here from our foundation chain, our chainless foundation, I should say. So the first one was just chains, and then there that is. So what we're gonna do is wrap twice, go into this first stitch, it's just that knot, pull it up, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two. You probably wanna hang on to that as you do it so that it doesn't get out of hand. So what we're gonna do is continue going. And now we have these full chains to work into. Now, I'm not a big fan of the chainless foundation. It does take a little bit longer, it feels like, because it takes longer than the chain, but then think about that you have to do a chain and go back. So doing the chainless foundation, it goes a little bit faster. So now what we're doing is working on, since we've twisted it, we're working on this end all the way around, and then we're going to slip stitch to this. I'll show you that when we get there. So we haven't finished the first round yet because there are two rounds, one on each side, to do the Mobius because we've done a twist. Now we're still working. We're just working the other half of the first round, and we no longer have to do that the chain because we're using it again. We already built the chain, we're using it again. And I'll just get to the end and I'll show you how I do that. I'm almost all the way around. I don't forget, after you stitch that last stitch, it looks like the last stitch, don't forget this chain. So we need to do one more treble into the top of that chain. Try to go under two strands. And now we've made it back around, and see, we have a fold in it. It's gonna be nice on the top of our head if we wanna do it like that. So, it's hard to tell with this pattern though, but so we're going to go to the top of this chain, because that's our first treble, and we're going to slip stitch. And I was gonna say also, what's really good about the chainless foundation is that there's a lot more give to it. And especially when you're doing something like a headband, and I'm doing this in trebles because it's going to somebody that lives in Texas. I'm in Texas. And so it gives it a little bit of breeze. Now the super bulky, I'm not so sure about, but it gives it a little bit of a breeze. So if you need it to really stay warm, like warm, like below freezing, you probably need to stick with a double or a half double to keep it nice and tight, so the wind can't get in. Now, you might notice that there's a big old gap right here. Now, I left a little bit of a tail. Now, this tail I'm gonna use to go, well, I may need to use the end tail to go up and down and sew it together, at least in the middle. I can use this tail to just do the middle, and then it'll just be held together like all the other ones are. And that way, it's not that big old gap. You don't want to leave that there. So go back in and attach the centers. There's probably a better way. If you know a better way of doing that as you go, as the first time around, will you leave it in the comments? Because I've been curious about that. Okay, so we're not done. although elapsed time is probably only about 15 minutes. This is a 30-minute cowl, so, you know. So what I'm going to do after I slip stitch into that chain, now I chain one, and I go back into that slip stitch place and do a single crochet. Now I'm going to do a single crochet all the way around, which means around both sides, but you don't even have to pay attention. You're going to know when you get back to this single crochet that you're done. But doing a Mobius, you're going to go all the way down here, 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 past that center point, go back around here, 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 and get back to the chain one where you will, I should say that, where you will slip stitch, and then we'll be done. So I just twisted everything all up. Okay. So I'm going to finish single crocheting, and then I will meet you back at the end. Got all the way around with my single crochet. Go to the first single crochet. So it's on, I just did one round, it felt like, and it's on both sides because of the way that it's twisted. So you just keep going until you get to the first one. And then you can slip stitch to it. And then we're going to finish off. Now, we're going to have to hide this tail. Let me do this one first, make sure I can get it with this. I thought I was leaving a longer tail, but I did not. So we're going to thread this little tail from the beginning. And I'm going to first put it in through around this chain and back through this knot to pull it together. Now go back to what I'm going to call the inside. And now I'm going to go through these stitches a few times, as long as it'll let me. Meaning until I run out of yarn. Looks like just twice. There we go. Cut that off. And now I'm going to thread this last tail. Turn to what I'm calling the inside, because it could be either one. Laying this way, so I go into this stitch right here to the center of that stitch and then pull it down through so that that knot can get kind of pulled into a stitch. You don't see it as much. Then find something to go back and forth on. I like these stitches up top. Try to do three times if you can. That's the magic number that I learned from Mikey. Mike, Crochet Crowd. Mikey? Two. One more. Is three. So I call this the 30-minute cowl. But really the only way this is going to take you 30 minutes is if you count the time that it takes you to choose your yarn and get your stuff out. Because, not cowl, 30-minute headband. If you get all the stuff, if you count all the stuff to make it with and getting it out and getting it ready to go, then it'll take 30 minutes. So, here's the headband. I haven't done my makeup yet, so let's use her. She hasn't done her makeup yet either. Although, this camera is very low. I'll put it picture in too, but I want you to see kind of, oh, it didn't work. Funny, funny, funny. Just make sure that the knots or the ends or whatever are somewhere in the back, and it goes over your ears really nicely and you can't see anything. But there's the fold, the Mobius fold on the front of her. So I will certainly put in a picture, a couple of pictures, so that you can see everything here at the end of the video. But that was very, very quick, a very quick little gift or a very quick something for you. You can make the night before that's gonna match the outfit that you already have picked out to wear. Find some yarn that matches and go for it. Now, I teach in a high school and these little headbands are coming back, and I've worn them to work and they're not a hat, so I can wear them all day, which is nice because right now in the wintertime, yes, I know I'm in Texas, but in the wintertime, it just doesn't seem to get warm in that school. So there you go. There's the 30-minute headband, Mobius headband. You could pull it all the way down and have it be a really, not really tight, but kind of a tighter cowl. But if you measure it for your head, then you know that it'll fit around your head. So measure from the top of your head around your ears and back to the top, and you should get about 22. So if you're making it for somebody else, 22 is probably good. You can go for 21, and then there's a stretch in it, so that'll be okay. Okay, so thank you very much. I hope you learned something fun, and thank you for your time. And we always have a choice, so please choose happy. Thank you. Bye.